Sure. So the I will explain the SkyG gasoline engine more detail. And our new SkyG gasoline engine is developed to contributing to better fuel consumption. And at the same time, I want the engine to deliver more low end torque, and which gives the engine more flexible and make it easier to keep the engine in a more efficient part of its operational range during the normal driving. And of course, because we are Mazda, so our engine needs to be lightweight and also the width lively direct throttle response. SkyG concept. The chart on the right here shows where all the combustion energy goes when we burn the fuel in a typical gasoline engine. And you can see, depending on the engine load, we are losing 70 to 19% of fuel energy. And this gives you a good idea of what a tremendous amount of energy is accumulating in the gasoline, and how much opportunity we have to make better of it. And you can basically break these losses down into two categories. The top three, radiation, exhaust, cooling, are basically failure to capture the combustion energy and turn it into a useful driving force. So we need a more efficient combustion. The mechanical and the pumping losses on the bottom are energy loss moving the engine on internal parts. So we need a better mechanical efficiency. So we start by going back to internal combustion basic, and in any internal combustion engine, we press the air and the fuel, then capture the energy of the combustion with a power stroke that forces the combustion chamber to enlarge. The most basic thing we can do to extract more power is to have a bigger power stroke to capture all of the expansion that happens when that fuel is burned. And intuitively, it seems like a longer stroke is what you need, but in theory, it's the expansion ratio that determines how much energy we can capture. So our goal was to get the highest expansion ratio possible. And of course, since our piston have to go up the same amount it goes down, the expansion ratio is the same as a compression ratio. And because it's a compression ratio, it's at the present, at the most challenge, we talk about the high compression. And of course, the challenge with the high compression is a knock, as you know. And knock is caused by an air mixture, fuel mixture, self-ignition from the heat of a compression, and causing it to burn at the wrong time. The most of the effort to prevent the knock comes down to lowering the temperature during the compression stroke, so that mixture never reach self-ignition level or speeding up the normal combustion, so there isn't time for a knock to develop. Achieving these goals required really detailed study of a combustion process. And when you watch this video, notice how quick the combustion is complete in the SkyG combustion chamber. And on the conventional direct injection engine on the left, its slower combustion leaves more time for the self-ignition to happen. While fuel is burning on one side of a combustion chamber, this is increasing the pressure on the other side, creating a condition for knock. Then, so we spent 10 years studying high compression combustion dynamics in the preceded detail. and building a variety of very creative test engines and study in the cylinder flow and high compression combustion in excruciating detail. And in the end, we developed a web of interconnecting technology that lets us break away from the conventional compromise. And this, the first change is simply to switch to smaller bore and longer stroke. And small bore engine have a very compact combustion chamber, and which means a frame front can travel from a subplug to the edge of a chamber more quickly. And just as importantly, though, the same volume combustion chamber have a less surface area with a small bore. And this reducing cooling losses by keeping a combustion energy from a jetting sucked away into the cooling system. And this is much easier to understand if you think of it in terms of the starts rather than the engine. And if you want your coffee to stay warm until you drink it, you are better off keeping it a nice squared coffee mug than pouring it in a big flat saucer. Both cup and saucer have the same volume, but there is a more surface area saucer and more contact between the hot coffee and cold outside world. So maybe easy to understand. And next is a advanced direct injection system. As we already announced, explained, we launched the digital engine in Mazda Speed 6.3 and CX7. So the injecting fuel directly into a cylinder gives us a substantial cylinder cooling benefit. That cooling comes from the fact that direct injection required high fuel pressure, and high pressure injection cools better, sucks dramatically better atomization, and dramatically better evaporate cooling. For reference, our port inject engine inject fuel at 43 psi, and DC turbo engine inject fuel at 1600 psi. And for the SkyActive G, we push the fuel pressure to 2900 psi. And at the same time, we move from a single hole injector in the DC turbo to a six hole injector, as you can see from a spray pattern right side. And this improvement vaporization and cooling and mix the fuel more evenly for faster, cleaner combustion. And another benefit of a high pressure is that let us inject fuel faster, so fast, in fact, that we can split the fuel delivering up into multiple injection events. For example, at the low RPM, we inject once in an intake stroke and once during a compression stroke. This gets us both the best distribution of the fuel in the combustion chamber and the maximum cooling benefit. Finally, our study of airflow in the combustion chamber was so thorough that we've actually calculated how the spray of fuel affects the airflow pattern in the combustion chamber. And this spray guide temperature flow to carefully hone combustion process. Next, piston. Achieving high compression requires a dome-shaped piston to reduce the volume of combustion chamber. This diagram on the left shows the combustion chamber with a flat top piston from the current non-turbo DC turbocharger, current DC engine, which is available just only in Japan and Europe only. And this compression ratio is 11.2. And to achieve the compression ratio of the 15th in our development engine, we have to push the top of a piston up, as you can see the raw image like this. And the red ball here in the frame kernel in the critical first moment after the spark plug fires. When the frame front runs into a top of a piston, as it does with a high compression piston, two things happen. First, energy is lost heating the piston instead of driving the wheel. Second, this lost energy slows down the burn, and the longer it takes for all the fuel and air to burn, the more time is available for the fuel to spontaneously ignite somewhere else. The obvious solution to this problem is this Volcano top piston, shown the right bottom. And the fit makes a room for that initial frame kernel to burn. Of course, this solution seemed obvious when the problem is present like this. And the real engineering challenge was figuring out that this was one of the root cause of the combustion ratio challenge in the first place. And this chart shows compression ratio. So, this left side shows the SkyActive technologies work. And there is a two compression ratio. One is a 14 to 1, the another is a 13 to 1. And 14 to 1 is just for premium gasoline, so mainly in the Europe market. And the 13 to 1 is for regular gasoline. It means Japan, US, Australian market compression ratio is 13. Okay? And for the engine for a facelift Mazda 3, this new Mazda 3 is just a facelift model. So it means its platform is carried from the current model. So there is some limitation over spacing. And this SkyActive technology has a 421 exhaust system. And this 421 exhaust system is so big, so we couldn't house this 421 exhaust system into a facelift Mazda 3. So this exhaust touches the dash panel, and we couldn't fix it. So just we dropped this 421 exhaust system from the facelift Mazda 3. And this 421 exhaust system is equivalent to the compression ratio of 1. That means the engine for facelift, the engine compression ratio for the facelift Mazda 3 is 13 minus 1 equal 12. And the facelift Mazda 3 have the SkyActive engine for the US, Japan, Australia market only. So these three markets engine compression ratio is 12. Okay. So the next generation model, which have all SkyActive technology, engine, drive, chassis, body, this engine compression ratio is 13 to 1 for regular gasoline. It's a US, Japan, Australia market. And for European market, model have just only a 14 to 1 compression ratio. Okay. So we've covered the main ways that we're getting more energy from a fuel. Now let's look at some of the way we made sure the energy wasn't lost before it go to a wheel. And so this side of the project you will note some classic Mazda strategy, just like the Gram strategy. We used to shape weight from MX-5 and Mazda2. And our powertrain team adapts every source of the friction in the engine, no matter how small, piling up incremental gains until the total was a dramatic drop in drag. And I'm going to walk you through just six examples. So first is the oil pump. There is a huge variety of the parts in the engine that require oil pressure to work, from the bearing and valve train to hydraulic operating parts like a variable valve timing actuator on the exhaust cam and also the hydraulic rush adjuster on all the valves. And it can take a lot of power to pump all the oil. And in the SkyActive G, we use the array of torque, including an electrical controlled oil pressure regulator, to lower the pump losses by dramatic 74%. And we did similar attack on the water pump losses. Every water passage in the engine down to the fin in the radiator was redesigned to let the water flow more easily, and resulting in a 50% less pressure drop across the cooling system. And at the same time, the water pump itself was redesigned to the dramatically more efficient. So together, it takes 31% less energy to turn the water pump now. And reciprocating assembly, piston, conrod, and crank has also been reworked to minimize the drag. For example, the crankshaft has gone from a cast iron to a strong forged steel. So this allows the main bearing size to be reduced without losing crankshaft rigidity, and the smaller bearing have less drag. And the new crank is also a pound lighter, and the weight was also shaved from the piston and conrod, and also piston ring tension was reduced. So together, reciprocating drag is down to 25%. And also the valve train has gone from a come-on bucket to a roller locker design. And as you know, the locker has a much less friction. So total valve train friction down to 54%. Next is the pumping losses. So when you're just cruising around at part throttle, the engine actually wastes a lot of energy trying to suck air past almost close the throttle body. So please imagine if you were snorkeling and some joker put his thumb over your snorkel. Maybe you clearly understand what is the pumping losses. And to reduce these losses, we run at the right load with the slot wide open and use a new variable valve timing system to reduce the amount of air energy braced. And instead of sucking air past a closed throttle, the engine now braced fresh air in and then pushes some of it back out the open intake valve before starting the compression stroke, which technically makes mirror engine when it's running this condition. And this is a 13% easier than sucking across the throttle body. And in terms of BMW does something very similar with their valve tonic system, and as does Nissan with their VVEL system. Both of these systems are incredibly complex and therefore expensive, so they only use them on a high-end model. We've figured out how to accomplish almost the same improvement with a much simpler mechanism, so we can apply this to all our engine and all car, right down to the Mazda 2. And this chart shows the engine torque curve. So red one shows the current MZR 2.0 liter, and the black one shows the current MZR 2.5 liter, and the blue one shows the SkyG 2.0 liter, and you can see easily the SkyG, the torque, much improves the red one, and very similar to range of the 2.2 liter level. And this chart shows the engine efficiency. So scatter band shows the current gasoline engine level which available in the market, and red line shows the MZR 2.0 liter gasoline engine. So it's located the middle of the scatter band. And the purple line shows our 2.2 liter diesel engine for European market. And blue color shows the SkyG 2.0 liter gasoline engine. So you can see easily the SkyG level is already reached the diesel level. So it means the SkyG technology provides more power with less fuel. This is our concept, and I think we already reached this target level. So that's it. Thank you very much for attention.